Okay, I apologize for all the background racket in the that you can hear in the background. About four blocks from me, there is a huge 11-acre construction site getting ready to pop up, and so they're just getting medieval over there. So what I've got here is this is my new block plane. It's actually probably from the 60s or 70s. I got it on eBay. It's the first thing I've ever bought off of eBay. If you've seen some of my other videos, you know that I had another block plane that was almost identical to this. And so I have my Hawk replacement blade in this, and the block plane that I bought had that lever cap type arrangement on it, and it worked fine with this original blade here that had the smooth top. But my Hawk blade has the holes that go all the way through, so the little lever mechanism would fall into the holes and just didn't work right. So I modified the block plane by adding my own new post and taking the old knob off my old block plane and just using this lever cap, this pinch down cap, and so it works really, really well. And I'm doing a lot of block planing right now, and so I want to just take this old blade. You can see how rusted and pitted it is, and I'm just going to bring it kind of back to life and get it, you know, get it to where I can sharpen two blades and then just change it out. I don't think it'll be nearly as good as that Hawk blade, but it'll be really more than adequate. Now this thing was not ground, or whoever messed with it. I've never messed with this so far, but it's not square. It's quite a bit out, so I want to address that. And there's also a nick at the corner that I want to address, which is actually good because it's at the high end. And it just generally looks like somebody never sharpened this on a jig, because it looks kind of real rounded off and never, you know, never held at a flat facet angle. So I could put it in our Very Super Cool Tools jig, which, you know, I could get on with it and make something happen really quickly, especially with this extra coarse DMT stone that I have, or sandpaper. But what I'm going to do is I want to show you just the versatility of this jig. And by that I'm going to put this in, by that I mean I'm going to put this knife in the jig, and I'm going to get rid of a lot of this material really, really quick in just a minute or so, and straighten this out before I go to the stones. I'm going to do it on the belt sander, and I'm just going to show you a quick setup and just kind of show you just how versatile this jig really is. Okay, so let me go to the belt sander. So this is my big 4x24 Bosch belt sander. You can see I just made this contraption here out of two pieces of plywood, and they're really cut. I ripped them to the exact same height. They have bolts with wing nuts here that pinch that handle, and then a block that's screwed in from both sides. So I can really set this up in any position I like and have a real quick and dirty way to lock this beastly belt sander into the upright position, or the upside down position. So let me show you this this blade. Here's the blade that I'm talking about that came with my block plane that I got on eBay. And I'm sure this is going to be just fine, but I just want to fix it up a little bit. I've done a little bit of work on the back. I've dressed that sole just a little bit. I'll do it some more after I straighten this out. But you can see that I'm not completely square. I'm high over on this side, which is good because that's where that chip is, and I want to get rid of that. And also I want to go ahead and deal with the angle issue right now too. And so I've got my combination, my protractor head here, and I'm looking at this and I'm seeing that this is 28 degrees. So, you know, 20, this would work. I mean, it doesn't have to be exact, but, you know, ideally you want to be back to around 25. And so that means I'm gonna start here on the heel, and I'm gonna remove a little bit more material on the heel to start off with, since I'm gonna fix this. So I want to, you know, start back here, and it's gonna get bright on this side first. So let me put this in the jig, and I'll show you how the jig will work in conjunction with a belt sander. I could have done this on the on my Makita 9820 Waterstone also, but I'm not really sharpening planer and joiner knives right now, so I didn't want to get that thing out. So I'm just going to do it in this kind of quick and dirty method, because all I want to do is I just want to remove some steel really quick. You know, of course I'm not going to power down on this because I don't want to damage the temper of the steel or anything. So if it gets too hot for me to touch, that's too hot. So you'll see me constantly coming in and touching it with my thumb. You know, I mean, I don't want it hot at all. And but this belt sander, I've got it on the slowest speed, and the material is going to be shedding off the back. The heat's going to be shedding off the back that way, so it should be okay. Well, let me get this in the Very Super Cool Tools sharpening jig, and I'll get this straightened out. So let me get this knife in here. So I'm just going to slip it into the carrier, and in this situation, I'm gonna set it off to the side just a little bit so I can get my square in and, you know, make sure that I'm good and squared up. And sometimes I like to use this homemade wedge I made out of steel, and just so it's not going to interfere with the ruler when I stick the ruler up underneath there. So I'll just put that in there and tighten it down. Probably have way too much knife out. Yeah, let me actually bring it back in a little bit. Bring it back in. I just want to make sure that I'm clearing that. That looks good. Now let me check my squareness again. Perfect. So as I said, I want to start on the heel and work my way to the front. You know, you can see how pitted and rusted this is. I don't know how long this thing had sat before the guy decided to sell it on eBay, but I'm glad he did. I like it a lot. Okay, so I'm just going to put this block of wood up. This could, you know, vary in height. This is not that critical that it, you know, that it just be this height right here, because the jig can accommodate just about any angle that we want to put up there. So we'll just put this up here like this, and let me get down here and just put an eyeball on it. And like I said, I want to be back on the heel a little bit, you know, to get it to 25. That's good. And of course I have my homemade switches, you know, that I can turn the sander. You know, I'll have video on how to make those just out of old extension cords. Okay, yeah, I can see that. Yeah, that chip is pretty bad in the corner. That would have taken me forever. Why put the strain on your stones if you don't have to? And again, you're going to see me use really light back and forth passes. I don't want to let that steel sit in one place, and I'm constantly going to be feeling it and touching it to make sure that it's not too hot. Like I said, if I have to recoil from it because of the heat, I need to slow down and put it in some cold water. There's the first pass. See, I'm over here on the high spot where that nick is. You can really see that nick right now.